A good book, if it has the right messages in it, it can change a whole human being into something he never thought he would be. You know, in Sophiatown, we had very few educated Africans, but they were so broad in their reading. They all had books in their pockets. My husband was one of them. I don't think I would stay very long with him if he were different. When I applied for work, it was so difficult because we were still very young. My uncle would not have us working in the kitchens. So you were just hanging around doing nothing except going back to your books and reading about Thackeray and Dickens.
Miriam is an interesting woman. She published Muriel at Metropolitan in the 1970s. For people all over the world reading this book for the first time, they were getting an insight into what it was like to be black female oppressed living in South Africa.
They told me that it was the very first book written by an African woman in South Africa. I was proud. I knew it wouldn't be accepted. I didn't really mind about that. And I knew coming generations would pick it up and publish it. I was already now infused with the idea that I have to write everything. I think teachers, they form the very pillar of understanding of the life around us. We started a body of writers all together, blacks and whites, everybody. And we used to go out to the townships mainly. And we encouraged, especially the young ones, giving them a chance of learning about other writers. I think we can never do without our teachers.
Very nice. Keep looking. Big smile.
The portrait itself was very much Miriam in her work. A lot of these people are just simply so immersed and so closely tied with what they did. And I think that really is the epitome of Miriam's story.
There's so much that is interesting. It's amazing. There's so much, and I wouldn't be able to do it alone. But fortunately, there are so many of us already. I think now it is the time, and it doesn't come through the efforts of other people. It comes from inside you.